Hey, it's Peter Gregg, Miami, Florida. I've got the mics for the lapel in the kitchen. Anyway, I'm going in the pool, but I've been talking so much, and other people are now starting to talk about the overheating with the R7. So I wanted to address that elephant in the room. Let's start the whole shebang off by saying, is it a deal breaker? Should you not buy the R7 because of something I'm presenting to you? The answer is clearly no. This does not happen just like, bam, I turned the camera on and it overheated. This happens over like a long period of time or under certain circumstances. So what I wanted to do is explain that because people are going like, I don't want to buy the R7 because it's overheated. Well, I'm not an R7 salesperson. I do have a link to it in the description below, which actually helps the channel if you use that link. But I also don't want to be a person that causes people to flee and go away from an R7 that hasn't really done anything wrong to you. All right, that, in my opinion, would be a wrong thing to do, or send people in a wrong direction. So I'm kind of like what they call like an influencer, where I influence people. And some people will say, the R7 just overheats, so please don't buy it. I'm not saying that at all, all right? Any camera will actually overheat given enough time. So the point is to find out, is this something that would be something that would cross your path, your lane, your sword, okay? If it crosses something against what you want, then that would be bad. So the R7, I didn't even have a thought about it overheating at all in my mind. It never even occurred to me. And that's with the R5 and the R6, which is what you're watching right now, with their overheating woes, okay? And how they're there, why they're there, all that could be speculation or political or accusatory. You know, I believe Canon built that in just to make you buy the next camera. Well, that's an opinion. It's not my opinion, okay? I'm not going to tell you my opinion on that. This is not what this video is about. This video is about, let's find out, if you buy an R7, what's it going to take to overheat? So I already have one video where I showed you it overheating, and I'm about to make another one, not this one, I'm going to show you how to make it overheat. But this video is if you're using this camera outside in the sun. I'm in Miami. It's actually a 90 to 100 degree day out there. I'm going to go swimming. I'm going to take this camera. And I'm going to, because I've been losing weight, okay, I'm going to take my little baby Speedos and we're going to go swimming. If you believe that one, I got an R13 to sell you, okay? But I am going to go swimming, okay? That's why I got this getup on. I put gel in my hair because every time I go outside in the backyard, my hair blows from here to kingdom come. So I got my hat because it's that hot. I just took the garbage out. And just walking from the back to the front, I could feel it on my neck, and I'm going like, oh my God, I'm gonna get a sunburn. All right, so let's take this camera. I'm gonna put the 16 millimeter, which is very small, RF lens, because I wanna get a nice sweep of the pool. Gonna put the 16 millimeter RF 2.8 full frame lens. All right, so I got my t-shirt on. I got my Bermuda shorts on, and we're gonna go outside in the heat. I'm gonna put the camera on the tripod. I'm gonna hit record. It's got a fresh battery. I just charged the battery. We're gonna go from in here where it's nice and cold. All right, this room is air conditioned, nice and cold in here. I'm gonna put a fresh SD card and I'm gonna record into the camera. All right, so I'm gonna go out and record it. Let's run the footage.
Hey Siri. What's the temperature outside?
It's about 90 degrees outside.
90 degrees. Hey Siri, what's the feel-like temperature outside?
It currently feels like 99 degrees Fahrenheit.
So it feels like 100 degrees, okay? It really does. Honestly, it's hot. So the R7 is now recording. It's out. Direct sunlight on a tripod. I'm probably going to go in the pool, maybe. Okay, but we'll see what we got going on. Hey, you still with me? I'm in the pool. It's just too hot. I can't take it. So I'm swimming in the pool, and it's nice and cool in here, but it's going to warm up really quick. I got an air bubble in my bathing suit, so you got to kind of let that bubble out. This is kind of like the biggest whirlpool you've ever seen. So I'm cool, but the camera's hot. Okay, so that's what you got going. And the sun is hot. It is about 100 degrees, South Florida. You could actually swim in your pool and cool off. If you got kids, this is the place to be, is swimming in your pool and running your R7, your Canon R7. So I do have the external Rode stereo mic. Don't make mistake. It's not the Rode shotgun mic, which would make a very different sound completely. Now, since I'm in the pool, I'm not going to get out and come and unplug it so you can see what the natural sound is on the R7. Maybe I'll do that a little later. Remember, I don't know how long this is going to last. So let me just take a quick lap. To be honest with you, you know, I've lost so much weight since I'm on the keto diet. My bathing suit is dropping down. No, this is not that kind of a show, so just forget it. That will never make it into the video. We are running the R7 to see if you were shooting a wedding. Do you take this woman to be your officially wedded, whatever you want to call it? Yes, I do. Do you take this man to be your officially called, whatever you want to call it, your husband?
Yes, I do.
So you'd be out in the sun. You're stuck. Okay, so unless you got a hat big enough to cover your R7's going to be in the sun. If you're at your son's football game and he's out there and boom, he is just tossing that football and connecting all the time. Let's say he's the quarterback. It's my fantasy. Just put out, okay? What can I tell you? And I want to say hi to Mark Bennett. I made a new friend. He actually is a YouTuber online and he's been commenting and he's got a whole channel on cameras. I didn't even know it. So go check out Mark Bennett. And if I think about it, I will put a link down there. He's much better at YouTubing than me. So if you think I'm like one of the worst YouTubers around, go check Mark Bennett out. He's up in Canada, way up there. I'm in Miami. So Mark, we're not doing lunch anytime soon. I can tell you that. So here I am. Hello, how are you doing? All right, so I'm actually sitting in the pool in the hot sunlight in Miami, in the Miami heat. Boy, let me tell you something. The sky looks gorgeous. It's blue, blue, blue. And the clouds are all over. Pretty cloud. I don't know who decorated the sky. My guess is it was God, okay? But he did a really good job today. It's absolutely beautiful. I don't think this thing's going to last much past 30 minutes. So for all I know, it stopped recording. And I'm just talking to a camera. All right, so let me get out of the pool now and see if I could see anything. You didn't really think I was going to get out of the pool and stand before you naked, did you? This ain't that type of show. So I need to go check and see if we're still actually running or not. There you are. While I was inside changing my clothes, I dried myself off. I hung the bathing suit out there with the towel to dry off. And the camera overheated. So I will see what the time is and report it to you. And I just pressed the shutter button. We're off and running again. I don't know how long we're going to be running, but we're off and running all over again. So now you're dealing with me just walking out here. I might look dry on the outside, but I'm wet on the inside. I just quickly changed because I wanted to come and see if we had turned off. All right, so let's conclude this overheating test inside the Christmas room where I could talk like a normal person. All right, here we go.
Whoa, whoa, whoa. Man, is it hot out there. Crazy. All right, let me mic up. That would be better. This way you can hear me. I grabbed the mic in from the kitchen. So there we go. I'll put this in my pocket. Let me put the SD card real quick. All right, I put the SD card into the card reader. Let's open that up and see what happened. What happened? The camera stopped at 23 minutes and 36 seconds. So the very first clip, before you saw me go under the overhang, it's really hot. So before you saw me go into the overhang area where I spoke with the camera on the tripod after I got dressed when I came out of the pool, the camera had gone off. The overheating had happened. So it went to 23 minutes and 36 seconds. So that's this camera in this heat on this location. So if you're going to be recording anywhere in the 20 to 25 minutes on a consistent thing in red hot sun, that's the information you're going to want to know. If you're going to record taking pictures even at a wedding, like my mind goes to wedding routines. Now, if I was going to shoot a wedding outside, I would be careful of this camera and maybe other cameras. That's where you need to test. But if you're going to be shooting at, a family party, or a restaurant, or indoors, or even outdoors, and you're in the shade, you've got to know your equipment. So does that make this camera a deal breaker? Not in my opinion. I just need to know how to do it, when to do it, and why to do it. That's the point of photography, knowing how to work your gear. So I am not knocking this camera out. It's still one of my top recommended cameras. So each company has a highly recommended camera from me. And for the Canon, the R7, she's the one. Canon put the best stuff in this thing and it works awesome. So I got the 16 millimeter lens. It's an RF lens. It doesn't have image stabilization built into it, but it does have it. It does have a switch so you could turn the manual focus on and off so you don't have to go hunting. Although this camera body has a manual focus on and off in the front, where the one you're watching, the R6, doesn't have it. So in terms of convenience, in terms of smoothness of operation, the R7's got it. Yes, it's got it right everywhere it counts. So the area of weakness is not really the overheating, unless you have one specific situation, and that is you're gonna shoot out in the hot sun for long clips. If you're gonna shoot out in the hot sun and it's not long clips, nothing that says you can't put the camera, like hang it down behind you or down by the side by your leg, keep it, the body, out of the sun. Just something you need to be considerate of. And if you're shooting pictures and clips, you know, go into the menu. I'm going to make another video, okay? I'm going to show you how to defeat overheating on this camera in most situations, but I can't go against nature, okay, or the design of the camera. It's going to overheat if you put it out in the Miami 100 degree, 90 degree, whatever you want to call it degree, hot, and you're going to run a long clip, you're going to overheat, just plain as day. Now, here's something else that's very interesting. After you've overheated, if you just tap the shutter button, the camera went to sleep. Where unlike the R6, if you overheat and you just tap the shutter button, the camera's gonna laugh at you. Bah! We've overheated, baby. Time out. You go stand in the corner. All right? This doesn't do that. All right? It would. I have actually over. I'm making a video. I'm going to show you how to overheat this camera and what to do when that happens. All right, so this is still recommended. I like the camera. I am not making videos to show you why you shouldn't buy it. I want to expose an area that you need to have that knowledge under your belt so that you can use it when you need it. I'm not giving you knowledge to not buy the camera, except if you're gonna be shooting all your stuff on Miami Beach at the ocean, maybe this guy isn't the one for you. Maybe a camera that's got a fan built into it is something that you would look at. If your entire business is for you to be out in the sun all day long with your camera, you probably need a camera with a a fan. So on the Canon, it's the RF, R5C. On the Sony, it's the FX3. Okay, I'm trying to think. What cameras have fans built into it? And the new Fuji has got a fan that you could screw on. You open this and you could screw the fan on. All right, if you like this video, please subscribe so you can see the next one where I'm going to show you how to make it overheat. Thanks for being here with me. 23 minutes, 36 seconds, and it'll overheat at that point, and then you could restart it. How long you're going to get after that, I don't know. I got another 20 minutes, and then I stopped and came in here. You saw me coming in here all overheated. Peter Gregg, Miami, Florida. Bye. Wish.
You have just watched another Peter Gregg video. Something warm, human, and wonderful happens when you watch Peter Gregg. Thank you for watching.